Hi, good morning. My name is Mark Danish. I'll be hosting this webinar today for MicroStrategies. It's talking about how you're going to be overcoming your IBMI staffing challenges. So today, presenters will be myself. I'm a senior systems engineer with MicroStrategies. I've been with MicroStrategies for about 5 years. I've got over 25 years working with the IBMI platform. I also have experience with Power Systems, AIX Linux, some SAN storage, networking, and hyperconverged technologies.
And I'm Alex Messiger. I'm an architect with MicroStrategies. I have over 12 years of IT services management experience, and I've fulfilled a variety of roles from engineering to VCIO, and I'm versed in the latest ITIL version 4 certification.
Lydia GR, she's an IBMI administrator, part of our global support team. She's got 4 years of experience in iSeries, and she's also experienced in Power Systems, operating system upgrades, PTF management, HMC, system decommissioning, and migrations. So the topics we're going to talk about today are, is IBMI still relevant? How do I address my challenges, especially specifically with finding IBMI staff? And how we, as MicroStrategies, can help you? So is IBMI still relevant? IBMI is still relevant. 100,000 businesses still run some form of IBMI, be it OS 400 or iSeries. 43% of those surveyed say they run 76 to 100% of their core applications on IBMI. 24% of those say they plan to increase their IBMI footprint in the future. Only 1.3% surveyed report that they will be migrating away from the platform within 5 years. And IBMI has a footprint through at least 2028 for IBMI. So some of the things we're seeing today out in the market with IBMI specifically, some are regarding open source. Within the past few years, especially with the advent of OS version 7, IBM has allowed better openness with open source products. Some include Java, Python, Ruby, J2SE, et cetera. However, RPG is still a top development tool and language for IBMI. Some of the other questions we're being asked are regarding move to cloud. Is it for us? Cloud benefits, some of them are, there's no more on-premise hosting, your equipment is hosted by a cloud provider, and it does save your capital expenditures. The only thing you have to worry about is OpEx, which is your operating expenditures. However, cloud isn't for everyone. Cloud depends on the size of your environment, how much data you're uploading and downloading, and also how much equipment you have to host. So the need for continued support is still mandatory. The combination of platform longevity and retiring in-house experts requires this. 64% of the applications running today on IBMI systems are homegrown. That means developers are still writing and wrote code and they're still supporting that code that was customized for their customers or employers. Also, the need for support is still critical for uptime. Most companies need a 24/7 support staff or support matrix today, which requires that. The days of bringing down the system on a weeknight or a weekend night, backing it up and doing an IPL are long gone. As you know, IBMI is reliable and adaptable, enables in-house code to run on the platform for decades. For example, we've currently worked with a customer that was running an Advanced System 36 system that was purchased in 1985. It was a 9402 system that was successfully migrated to IBMI v7r3. Their code was migrated and they're currently running on a Power S914 today. It allows them a lot more functionality with the operating system and keeps them whole and profitable for years to come. So some of the new challenges that are out there. IBMI skills rank fourth out of the top 13 concerns of CIOs today. What this means is that CIOs still consider the platform important as it's ranked number 4 out of the top 13. Also, some companies can't afford to have a dedicated person for IBMI anymore. For example, we're currently in an engagement where the sole IBM I person is retiring at the end of January 2020. So MicroStrategy stepped in and was able to help them manage their system going forward, as well as learn their applications, apply their fixes, et cetera. Also, the IBM I, as you know, is a very individualized OS. You still need a support staff to have some kind of basic administrator knowledge to create your profiles, answer messages, release output queues, et cetera. Security is also a big top concern and a challenge to a lot of companies going forward today. Viruses and malware and ransomware are rampant. So a lot of companies do look for antivirus. And as you know, IBM I does have exit point program software security. And a lot of companies do require HIPAA and SOX requirements and reporting that does require specialized software. Also, companies are moving to multi-factor authentication, which also adds a layer of security and complexity sometimes to that platform. So large companies also want to move hiring dollars to emerging strategic technologies. So what that means is that a lot of CIOs and IT managers may see IBM I as a dated system because it's got green screen access, et cetera. But nothing, as you know, can be farther from the truth. But they do support it because it is running their core applications today. So how do I address some of my challenges? So hiring, you can go out and hire. As you know, though, the IBM I talent pool is dwindling. Your programmers and administrators are retiring. And a lot of new employees that are coming on board aren't interested in learning about the 5250 green screen applications. They're used to a point and click kind of Windows interface. Also, new hires are less willing to work second and third shifts. So a lot of people prefer a 9-to-5 job, Monday through Friday. Unfortunately, they don't like to work weekends, holidays, nights, et cetera. And the typical age of available talent makes their longevity uncertain. They might want to move to a new platform, a new technology, and how long is this person really going to want to stay supporting IBM I? Increasing hiring costs as competition for talent rises. Due to the programmers and admins that are retiring out there, folks who have an in-depth knowledge of IBM I come at a premium and are in very in demand. You've got the same number of companies that are out there, but you're competing for fewer bodies. So you can also consider migration. Migration can take years. Source code has to be reviewed and in some instances, rewrite and recompiled. Applications developed in-house may require substantial and costly rewrites. Costs can be very, very concerning. Moving to a whole new platform, say from a power platform to an x86 platform, could require more hardware, more power draw, different licensing, a support staff that knows the new product, as well as a new footprint or an expanded footprint. Disruption. Downtime is needed to do a backup and to do a migration. Case of problems, you need to have a full rollback plan. What happens if this migration doesn't go well, if it doesn't work? So you also now need more downtime to restore your old system back to how it was before migration started. So another option is outsourcing. What are some of the benefits that managed services provide? Well, it eliminates your need for 24/7 on-call staff. So their employees can now have their 9-to-5 job or their nights and weekends free. It also provides a more cost-effective method of contracting services and accessing talent. The talent that you hire is going to know the IBM I platform and the hardware in and out. Managed services can also offer proactive monitoring and alerting without the substantial cost. Also, some things that you're doing today can be automated, possibly. Staff is currently supporting your environment. We like to use our MSP alongside your in-house talent for knowledge transfer, especially running code developed in-house. This helps our staff learn your applications better and obtain the necessary documentation to run your systems. We also ensure that your systems are up to date with the latest patches. IBM releases security patches and emails every week regarding critical fixes and bugs. We make sure at your convenience and as needed that your systems are up to date with the latest patches and fixes. So how can MicroStrategies help you?
So thanks, Mark. This is Alex Messinger. I just want to go over with you guys a little bit about how MicroStrategies can help meet these challenges that we're seeing with our current customers and that the industry, in a larger sense, is starting to grapple with. Because I really think that Micro is in a great position to be able to take on these responsibilities and help with these challenges. And there's several reasons for that. One is that the Micro Strategies has technical expertise across a wide variety of disciplines. Not only have we been selling the entire range of IBM hardware and software for over 20 years, we have multiple practices in disciplines that are relevant to the IT landscape today. That includes disciplines in security operations, business process and content management, data analytics, hybrid IT, which includes public cloud and more beyond that. So we really have a wealth of a background and experience, and not only are the skills there, but we have multiple industry verticals that we have deep interaction with. In any way, anything from manufacturing, financial, and legal sectors to insurance, publishing, pharmaceuticals, and retail. So we really have a broad base to draw from, and we can take the experience that we gain in one area and apply it to our clients in all the other areas that we have. They benefit from that cross-pollination. That's one of the core advantages of an outsourcing partner. One other advantage from an outsourcing partner is that automation is really core to us being cost-effective, efficient, and providing value. So we really rely a lot on modern monitoring tools, and these tools allow us to proactively address issues before they happen. This minimizes downtime for you, the customer, and also helps minimize or eliminate entirely, in many cases, impact to your revenue. Because a system that is maintained proactively is one that can't make unpredicted disruptions to your business. In pursuit of meeting the needs of the current landscape, the IT landscape, we've developed a global footprint, and we really believe in being a native 24/7 company. That means that your business, we recognize the fact that your business doesn't stop after 5 p.m., and so neither should any provider that you bring on to help run your IT environment. So we don't stop after 5 p.m. We monitor, diagnose, address, and resolve issues before shift one comes on board. And I want to also talk a little bit, that gives you a little bit sense of our background and where capabilities are. However, it's a very competitive landscape, and I do want to go over a little bit and with your guys' time to point out what makes MicroStrategies a little different. We see other smaller providers offering support for IBM software and hardware. We see larger providers offering similar services, and we see similar size providers offering these services. So I'm just going to go real quick into each one and what we see as our advantages for each of those categories. For, again, smaller providers, I want to talk a little bit about the bus principle. And you may have heard this before. It's the idea that there should be a way to continue operations in the face of any single person being metaphorically, and I stress metaphorically, hit by a bus. We're all human. There's many reasons why a person may become unavailable. And part of one of the big advantages of outsourcing your support is that you get a whole team. There's no one person that serves the critical link, losing one single person, availability for one single person is not going to make everything grind to a halt. So we really mitigate that risk of running a small in-house IT department. We apply ITIL-based processes and practices. So if you've ever tried to implement ITIL-based processes internally and seen how difficult, or even if you've had success, you know how much time it takes to invest into upgrading your processes. When you hire a partner like Micro, that comes along with it out of the box. So we, just going back to what I said before, we really are truly 24/7. We have the ability to triage, escalate, and resolve issues proactively on all three shifts with our global footprint. Pivoting a little bit to larger providers, we have clients today that have chosen us over other competitors that are household names because there's really no substitute for a company that's closer in size to your own. And that means that to us, you're not just a number. You're not just customer number 4327, right? One of the other approaches that we take that's pretty unique is that we have a dedicated account team for every single one of our managed services clients. They're really critical to bridging that gap between having an efficient, repeatable processes, IT service management processes, and automation, and your business's unique needs. So they make sure that you're just not just another cookie cutter client, that our processes are changed and modified to meet your specific needs, to change as your business needs change as well over time. And they're a local team. You'll see them face to face. They're not going to be located in Omaha, Nebraska, and you will never see them except via video. So that we find that's a big selling point for our ability to service our clients in the Northeast region. Against similar providers, we also have some great advantages, I think, that position us well. We have multiple IT practices under one roof. Probably the most relevant that we get the most interest in is having a security operations team underneath the same umbrella as Micro. This allows one-stop shopping in a lot of cases in terms of what the highest interest of needs for IT services are today, but also it lets managed services benefit from the in-house expertise that a dedicated security operations team can provide. So even if you're not subscribed to our security services, your managed services team benefits from having dedicated security resources in-house and very close to us, both physically and organizationally. Not only have those advantages, but we also have made a commitment throughout the organization from leadership on down to that we're not going to be long-term, we're not going to be outsourcing any internal services. So this means that when you hire MicroStrategies, you're hiring all MicroStrategies employees. In most cases, we're not going to be outsourcing any of our core functions that you deal with on a day-to-day basis. We feel this makes a big difference versus other providers that when they do outsource, you can have a lot of turnover and a lot of churn in terms of the people you interact with. I don't want to take up too much more of your time. So I thank everyone for listening to me on this segment. I hope I've been able to show you why Micro is a great place to help you with your IT challenges. It's really our sole focus here, and we couldn't do it without our partners and our customers, which we very much appreciate. I think now we're going to open it to some questions, right?
Great. Thanks, Alex. Just wanted to see if anybody had some questions out there. As Colleen mentioned at the beginning, you can chat in any questions that you may have. We did have a few that came in, so what I'll do is I'll handle those first, and then if you can think of anything else, please let us know. So one of the questions I had was, how many administrators do most clients have for IBMI? So really that depends on the size of your environment. From what I've seen in the industry, it's 1 up through 3, depending on also how many locations you have. If you have multiple locations, sometimes you have multiple people running it in different locations. Another one that came in was what kind of business applications are customers running today on AI? As mentioned, a lot of programs are homegrown programs that are running in-house. Manhattan Associates is another big piece of software that runs. JWalk, Enrich is one. Oracle, JD Edwards is another. Let's see, one more is, what are some of the greatest IBM security challenges you see your customers facing? From what we've seen with our customers is finding loopholes, how to actually identify those loopholes on the system and going through and closing those loopholes, as well as finding the time, I think, to really be able to patch the system. A lot of fixes, as you know, do require downtime for the system. So being able to schedule those patches and fixes that go on is also a big concern. So those were some of the questions that we had. If there's anybody, like I said, that mentioned, if anybody else has any questions, feel free. If not, our contact information is here. Thank you very much for your time. Again, my name is Mark Danish. I am the Senior Systems Engineer responsible for IBM I. My email is below. Alex Messiger, who is our MSP architect, and Srividya, who also is part of our global IBM I team. So I thank you, and if that's it, well, I guess we'll close things up. Have a good day, and thank you very much.